Hello, and welcome to another episode of What's on Draft. I'm your host, Tom, and today we're going to be having beers at Ebullition and chatting with a friend. We're sitting here with Morgan Tenwick from Modern Times Beer, and I'm so glad that we finally get to sit down and have a pint together. We don't get to do it very often.
I miss you.
I do miss you. This is actually the first unscripted episode of season 3.
I'm really interesting, so that's a great call on your part.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. But no, so you're advanced Cicerone, you're running the lab at Modern Times, which is one of the best breweries in the city.
Hey, thanks.
Yeah.
Say more nice things. This is great.
I tried to take the server Cicerone and I scrubbed out. Couldn't do it.
Yeah, no, I do love this industry. I left the biotech pharmaceutical industry to do this, which is kind of crazy on paper.
Right.
Like, oh, you want to be poor.
Cool. Yeah.
I mean, I've told you this before, but when I left biotech, the reason I left was because it was so competitive and cutthroat and, you know, there's no collaboration whatsoever, which is really crappy when you're thinking about what they're trying to accomplish. Let's all help each other save lives. But when I came to beer and it's like, yeah, how do you guys do that? Here's my recipe and here's, like, let me come and show you how to do it. And then it's like a completely different world, super friendly and collaborative. So I love it. And I always try to do my part. Like if someone comes to me needing help or whatever, I do whatever I can. And it's reciprocated everywhere.
You like guest bartend, like celebrity bartend at like Epic and Sparsi Nombre?
I do love bartending. Fall, McKellar, whoever wants to pay me that day.
I kind of want to do some celebrity bartending.
You should.
Yeah.
It's fun.
How do you get into it? People ask you.
Have you ever bartended before?
Yeah, a long time ago.
Okay, well let's.
I was a server in college. I wasn't very good at it.
Okay. Is this a real patent on the wall? That is so rad.
Yeah, the art in here is pretty awesome, isn't it?
God, I want to just read. I want to take some time to read all of these walls.
We'll bring you back up. We're having a bunch of events for our season 3 and the sexy calendar, and we'll make sure we can get you a ride up here and back, which makes it easier. Or you can crash at Rick's house.
Yeah.
He's probably got a couch.
Probably has a couch.
What is your title at Modern Times?
QA manager.
QA manager.
I don't have a fun wizard title.
You're a wizard though.
Sure, yeah, we're all wizards.
I imagine you get free coffee, which is dope.
Yeah, we get free coffee. The coffee beer perks, two of my favorite liquids.
Yeah. Coffee beer, it goes together quite well. Even like IPA, like Marty does that coffee IPA.
That's really that's good. Hard to do too.
Yeah.
The light roast.
Marty's
amazing.
Yeah, he's pretty awesome.
Shout out to Marty.
Shout out to Marty. On that note, what are some other breweries in town or around the country besides Modern Times that you love?
I always have a soft spot in my heart for Society, as I think everyone does. Burning Beard, obviously. Alpine, I'm from Alpine. Sierra's always got a soft spot in my heart. Yeah. Sierra's always at all the conferences that I go to, all the nerdy conferences, and they always have really awesome research and cutting edge stuff that they want to share. Yeah. So,
is that a problem? The brightness changing, is it okay? Not noticeable? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm just autistic. It's fine. I'm on the spectrum, probably.
Yeah.
I feel like I am.
Yeah.
Moving on. So this is our Ebullition coffee style, but you brought some stuff from Modern Times. We can actually crack one of these open if you want.
Let's do it. A little ice.
Ice, my favorite. Pilsner.
Ooh,
so good.
Favorite Pilsner.
This is my favorite beer right now.
Me too.
100%. It's so my favorite.
I knew I liked you.
So I'm gonna drink an ice.
Can I have one?
Majestic Mountains of San Diego? No. I'm keeping all the rest. But yeah, I was worried about this initially, but because it's a private event, we're allowed to do this.
Oh, great.
You know?
Perfect, yeah.
I know you were very worried about the legalities of it, I could tell.
I was, that's definitely my forte.
Yeah.
Well, cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Biggies up.
Exactly. I really like the style, and I'm very glad that you can it all year now, right?
It's not as
hopefully.
Seasonal.
We're trying to make it year-round. It's kind of a sales-driven thing right now, so.
Get out there and buy ice so that I can have it all the time. Because it has crushed up diamonds in it. That's why they call it ice.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Like Goldschlager?
Yep.
But you own a piece of Modern Times though, right?
I do.
Isn't that how it works over there?
It does, yeah. The employee ownership. So we get, it's actually really awesome. Mm-hmm. We're the first in California, which is amazing.
Yeah, we went out to New Belgium during JBF and they're 100% employee owned.
Like, what,
Modern Times is 30% employee owned, I believe.
Yep.
And that's a really cool step forward. Hopefully we'll see more breweries doing it, but it's really cool that Jacob took that step.
It's amazing.
How does it work exactly?
Essentially, he has to buy out some of our investors so that we can have divvy up that ownership to the employees. But you get a portion based on different seniority levels and salary, whatever.
Okay.
So the pie gets divided and everyone owns a piece of that. So you get vested over a 6-year period. Okay. And after 6 years, depending on what the company's valued at, your portion is worth a certain amount. It's kind of like a little retirement fund.
That's really cool.
If we're worth anything in 6 years.
Yeah, I think you will be.
That's the plan.
Modern Times is moving in a cool direction.
Yeah.
You guys are Type 01 now. You're a big brewery. You're not big beer, but you're in Portland, you're in LA.
I really like this business model though. Mm-hmm. Just opening smaller production facilities, smaller, you know, 30 barrel, just around the country and trying to get fresh beer distributed in that small radius as opposed to one big factory spreading it across the world.
Yeah, I want to go out to Portland and visit. I've actually never been to Portland.
It's my first time.
You went out for the soft opening,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, last month.
So yeah, LA, Portland, and then Anaheim is still like in process, right?
A really big project.
I'm excited for that one because there's going to be a swimming pool there,
right? There's a swimming pool. We're going to have a Modern Times lifeguard on our payroll.
Yeah. Oh my God, are you accepting applications? Because
right.
Aaron was like on the dive team.
Was he really?
He was YMCA dive. He had to do the whole like swim 10 laps to pass the thing.
Nice.
Aaron would be a great Modern Times lifeguard.
That's amazing.
Make him wear his Speedo that he had to wear in competitions in high school.
Yeah.
I would imagine it's required.
Probably still fits.
Has a little MT right here.
I saw I actually had dinner with George Thornton last night.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I saw his naked mash tun pic.
Yeah, his sexy bath time.
Yeah,
with
sexy
the rubber
bath
duckies.
Time.
I got 50 rubber duckies, put them all along the mash tun.
That's beautiful.
When it comes to like being a beer expert, there's sort of two different certifications, right? There's like BJCP and Cicerone. Like, what are the difference between the two?
I have both.
Oh.
And I'm actually trying to up my BJCP rank. They're different. I mean, they both have their value.
So you're BJCP and Cicerone.
Yeah, BJCP has different levels.
Right.
So you can continuously, you know, increase in the BJCP program as well.
When do you level up and become a Charizard or whatever?
No, the BJCP is very much just focused on judging and styles and being able to critique a beer, whereas Cicerone's more like you have to be able to design a draft system and talk about mash chemistry and also do like off flavor and descriptive panels as well. So it's kind of like just two different focuses.
Okay.
But they're both valuable.
What were we talking about? I don't remember. Doesn't matter. None of this matters.
None of this matters. Did you see my doctor's form that I had to fill out?
Oh, yeah.
Good God, man.
You lied to your physician?
Well, I lied, and then I still got creamed for being an alcoholic.
Really?
And I thought I gave a conservative answer.
So you were given like a conservative answer, like, yeah, I only have like one beer every other day.
The question was phrased, how many times a year do you drink more than 4 drinks in a day? How many times in a year? And I was like,
At least once a week.
And I said once a month. And they were
like, that's too much?
And so I got pamphlets sent home with me for binge drinking. And I was like, once a month constitutes binge drinking?
What kind of pamphlets would they have given you if you'd told them the truth?
Right. God, yeah.
They just check you into an outpatient clinic.
Yeah, no comment. I brought way too much beer.
Yeah.
I never know how much beer to bring, so I always bring too much.
I'm gonna give one of these to our camera operator.
So this is a kettle sour with a metric F ton of fruit.
Oh, cool.
Very heavily fruited.
And it's vegan. Isn't that lovely?
All the beers are vegan. And then Stencil Crew is our most recent hazy IPA.
Hazy IPA. People love hazy IPAs,
apparently,
man.
Yeah. I'm really adamant that hazy beers do not contain yeast. So the hazy is lazy part is laughable.
Right.
Because this beer actually, as an IPA, sits in the tank probably 50% longer than a clear IPA would.
Really?
So we have to cold crash it and then we centrifuge it to remove the yeast. But it also has to like condition and we almost lager these beers.
What gives it the cloudy appearance? Is it just hop particulate?
Just the combination of having protein and super heavy hop loads and you form these protein polyphenol complexes that create a stable haze.
Okay.
I love me a clear IPA, but I also think that hazies get hated on a little too much.
Yeah.
It's hard to make a really heavily dry hopped IPA that's clear. So the more hop load you throw in there, the more haze you're gonna create. And if you want to, you know, put that through a plate and frame, you can make it clear again, but you kind of pull out some of that
flavor,
awesome,
and aroma.
Expensive hop character.
So if you don't use fining agents and you don't filter it, that's basically all it is.
Right.
But if it's done correctly, it's not yeast.
It's not yeast.
It's not yeast.
It's not lazy either.
Yeah.
If you do it more from a flavor and mouthfeel standpoint and less from an aesthetic appearance, like you're trying to target a certain mouthfeel and flavor saturation, then it just naturally is hazy. But if you're just trying to make it hazy for the sake of being hazy, then you're a dick. Do you want to drink either of these?
On camera or just in life?
I mean, either.
Cheers to the Stencil crew in LA. Oh, that smells amazing.
I love smelling out of can mouth openings.
Yeah, Eric, can you give us two cups?
Thanks, Eric.
Thanks, yeah, dude.
Your rectum.
This is Eric, by the way. Are you still rolling?
Yeah.
Okay. What's up?
Don't make this awkward.
You made it awkward. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, we just cheersed empty glasses. Come on.
But we're filling up the glasses.
We're better than that.
I think we nailed it. That's all we need. You did great. Thank you for coming up here.
My pleasure.
That is it for this episode of What's on Draft. We will see you on June 11th in 2 weeks with a brand new episode, Speed Dating in the Mirilani Makers District. Cider, wine, whiskey, beer, sake. Oh my. You want a beer now?
Yeah.
You gotta keep your camera operator well lubricated. Rule number one of independent filmmaking.